Gets out the race and caught, it doesn't really help ask a lot at the back of the field. Jamie McGregor has that one well detached from the main body of the field as they go to jump the second. And on the front end is Jane Cobbler, a hairy leap on the outside and almost unshipping rider is Mark Millan. Jamie McGregor and ask a lot bring up the rear, not made the left hand turn yet, but Jane Cobbler is in the front. Well, through for second is Tim's approach. The little young colours of Lucky Bell is Van Meren third. Then Mark Millan, an unshipped rider as Tim's approach, at the third, the open ditch. So two have gone out of the race, leaving nine, and Jane Cobbler for the Victor Thompson, powerful Victor Thompson stable, who fights for his head under the steering of Tristan Davidson. But Tristan says we're going fast enough, we'll haul you back a little bit. Beautiful second is Lucky Bell, then Vreeland through for third. Lady Brooke is in the orange and black. On the inside of that one is Cherry's Bay. Next to that is Mark Millan, the one who brings up the rear. The main body of the field is Northern Flame, and it's Terry Foy Park. We've lost William's brother Lucky Bell at that one. Jockey Andrews just still to rise, so it's a very depleted discard of the field. We wish Mr. Richardson up on his feet as soon as we can, it's across the next, and it's still on the front end, Jane Cobbler. So Jane Cobbler has about a 4 or 5 minute break from through for second. Goes Wellesley, who's cut his way through the field for Colin McCormick. Reeland's in third, then fourth, in the orange and black is Lady Brooke. Still at the back of the field, no hurry from Kit Alexander on Northern Flame. And Amy McGregor and Ascalot is still well detached from the main body of the field and coming home in their own time. So they're swinging towards what will be the second last in the circuit's time. And there's loose horses everywhere. There's three loose horses. And on the front end, it's still Jane Cobbler. So Jane Cobbler has about a 7 or 8 length advantage from through on the inside goes Lady Brooke. Widest of that one is Reeland. Wellesley's bang there. So they come to what will be the last in the circuit's time. And Jane Cobbler takes it about 7 or 8 lengths clear. Well, through for second goes Wellesley. Then we've got Reeland, then Cherry's Bay, then Mark Millan, and then Northern Flame. The race lies between these six runners as it's hard to see Ascalot and Amy McGregor making up the ground, so they're up the one away from the start. And spring-heeled in front is Jane Cobbler. He's a 20 length advantage over Reeland, who steps off in chase. A slight mistake at the back end of the main field from Northern Flame and Kit Alexander. He's preceded by Mark Millan. So it's Jane Cobbler, Reeland, Wellesley. But Jane Cobbler heads away towards the far side of the track, towards the open ditch with 5 left to jump in the Smiths Gore and SG Sporting Maiden Division 1, Open Maiden Division 1, and Jane Cobbler. Reeland is closing it up a little bit in second. Through for third goes Cherry's Bay and Ed Ridley, then Wellesley. Then Mark Millan. Another slight mistake at the open ditch from Northern Square. It's difficult to see that one making up the leeway. And the main body of the field, Jane Cobbler, still goes along with 4 left to jump in the Smiths Gore SG Sporting 4, 5, 6 and 7 year old Open Maiden Division 1. Jane Cobbler, but Reeland sets off in a push. Steve Fox is on the end of this. He's heading off on the tails of Jane Cobbler and Tristan Davidson. These are about 12 to 15 ahead of Cherry's Bay, who in turn is ahead of Mark Millan, who in turn is ahead of Wellesley, who in turn is ahead of Northern Flame. So Jane Cobbler and Reeland, the race looks to lie between these two, Cherry's Bay. Now asked for an effort by Ed Drinkley. Starts to close. Jane Cobbler was much quicker in the air than Reeland, and they've got 3 left to jump in the opener, and Jane Cobbler for Tristan Davidson hustled all the time for the lead by Reeland and Stephen Fox. Jane Cobbler again a little bit swifter through the air, takes a 3 or 4 left advantage out of the box straight with 2 left to jump in the Smith Gordon SG Sporting 4, 5, 6, 7 year old maiden. Jim Cobbler. Again, closing the gap on the flat is Wheeler. Those have gone 10 clear of through for third is Cherries Bay. And the race lies between these three. Jim Cobbler. Here's Wheeler coming back for another go on the outside. So they're straight for the judge with two left to jump. It's Jim Cobbler for Victor Thompson and Tristan Davidson, and Reland in the beige and green for Stephen Fox. There's nothing to choose between the two, and Reland now goes to the front in between the last two. Reland, Steve Fox gives the Seahawks. He's got a length clear, but nothing if not game on the far side is Jim Cobbler. They're almost in the air and the last together. This side in the green is Reland, and on the far side in the red is Jim Cobbler. Left towards the line, he's got a very close call. Reland passing the distance from Jim Cobbler, half a length between it. Through for third is Cherries Bay. Wellesley takes the last in fourth, and Northern Flame will be fifth. And the last one to finish, if we go wrong, is Ascalon and Amy McGregor.